We are going to study science chapters of grade 10 SEE exams in this video series, and now we are going to study astronomy and geology part chapter history of the earth. This is part 3 of the chapter. Now we are going to study topic geological time scale. So geological time scale is all about the earth. Okay, when the earth was born, when it was formed, what is its age, what events occurred in it up until this time. So it is to know about the earth's history, right? Definition of geological time scale. To define geological time scale, geological time scale can be defined as the time scale, time period that covers earth's history from its origin to the present time. So the time scale that covers earth's history from its origin to the present time. So this is geological time scale. Now you see the age of the earth is 4600 million years. Okay, 4.6 billion years. 4600 million years. Okay, now this long time period of million years is divided. Okay, divisions are made to make this long time period easy to study, right? So big divisions are made, small divisions are made, more smaller divisions are made. The largest among them is eon. Okay, eon is the largest division. After that, eon is divided into eras. Eras are divided into periods, and periods are divided into epochs. Okay, so eon, era, period, epoch. Eon, era, period, epoch. These are the time divisions. Okay, these are also called time intervals, time chunks, or time blocks, etc. Now 4600 million years long time has been divided into two eons. So these two eons are cryptozoic eon and phanerozoic eon. Cryptozoic eon and phanerozoic eon. Cryptozoic eon is also called Precambrian eon. Precambrian eon, right? And Phanerozoic eon. Now these eons are divided into eras. Cryptozoic eon is divided into Archean era and Proterozoic era. Combinedly, this can be called Azoic era. Azoic era, right? So this is Precambrian eon. Now in Phanerozoic eon, you see this is divided into three eras. 1, 2, 3. Paleozoic era, Mesozoic era, Cenozoic era. Paleozoic era, Mesozoic era, Cenozoic era. Now these eras have been divided into periods. Now these are the periods. Under Paleozoic era, you can see Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian, right? Under Mesozoic era, you can see Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous. Under Cenozoic era, you can see Tertiary and Quaternary. Yes, so these are the periods. Now these periods are further divided into epochs. These are the epochs. In case of Paleozoic and Mesozoic, there are no epochs, so we can see epochs under Cenozoic, Tertiary and Quaternary. Tertiary has been divided into this epochs. You can see over here Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene, Pliocene. Okay, so Paleocene, Eocene, Oligocene, Miocene, Pliocene, right? And Quaternary has been divided into Pleistocene, Holocene, Recent. So we are here now in Recent. Pleistocene, Holocene, Recent. So these are the epochs. Okay, eon, era, period, epoch. So this table is to make geological time scale table simple, simplified version of geological time scale. Now we are going to see actual geological time scale, right? So geological time scale. This is geological time scale, the actual table. Actually, this table should be upside down. Okay, so this one, this is the oldest one. This should be at the bottom, and this is the current one. This should be at the top. Okay, according to rule, it is according to the strata present in sedimentary rock. Okay, sedimentary rock contains fossils of living beings, so this keeps the record of geological time scale. So in sedimentary rock, the oldest ones are deep inside, okay, and the current ones are on the top. Okay, so by following the same pattern, this would be actually this side at the bottom and the current one should be on top. But in order to make the study easier, it is made this way upright. Okay, anyway, now you see geological time scale, time period I have told you. Two eons are there, Phanerozoic eon and Cryptozoic eon. It is also called Precambrian eon. Right, so Phanerozoic Precambrian eon covers almost 3000 million years, and Phanerozoic eon covers very little time of geological time scale. As you can see over here, Precambrian eon 4600 million years to from the beginning to 570 million years, almost 3000 million years time is covered by Precambrian eon. Yes, 88%, it covers 88%, whereas Phanerozoic eon covers only 12% of the time of geological time scale of Earth's age. Right, so in Phanerozoic eon, living beings were evolved, they lived on the Earth. So living beings lived on the Earth much later. Yes, so only 12% time is covered by Phanerozoic eon. Now this eon is divided into periods. Yes, Archean eon era and Proterozoic era under Precambrian eon. Precambrian, this is Cambrian and this is Cambrian, okay, and Precambrian before Cambrian. Yes, now eras under Phanerozoic eon, Paleozoic, Mesozoic, Cenozoic. These eras are very, very important to study for examination point of view. You need to learn everything about this eras, right? So eras have to be studied from this table. Now Paleozoic, Mesozoic, Cenozoic eras. Now you can see their time period also, right? Paleozoic 570 to 225. After that Mesozoic 225 to 65 million years, and Cenozoic, which is present time, which is going on 65 million years before to present, right? This is Cenozoic. Okay, now these are again divided into, you know, periods. Paleozoic is divided into this one, and Mesozoic, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous. This part you have to study. Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous period. And under Cenozoic, Tertiary, Quaternary. These are epochs. And this column is for evolution taking place in plants and animals, flora and fauna. Yes, flora and fauna. Yes. And the climatic changes in this column. Okay, there are small changes about geographical state also, we'll see here. So geographical time scale is all about evolution taking place on the Earth, right? What happened to living beings? How did they, you know, come to existence, and what happened to them? Yes, how simple living organisms were, you know, developed, okay, gradually changed to make complex organisms like mammals, right? So this is about evolution, right? So geological time scale shows that evolution has occurred on this Earth. Now if you study this column, then it is very clear, it becomes clear: air, water and soil on the Earth in the beginning, right? And unicellular organisms appeared, that is in Precambrian era, right? Okay, and after this, marine invertebrates, Paleozoic era. Marine invertebrates and shelled invertebrates appeared, then Pisces, then first green plants, then amphibians, then winged, insects and first reptiles. Okay, green plants, and extinction occurred at this point of time, Permian period. Extinction of vertebrates and invertebrates took place most probably due to ice age. Scientists say so. Okay, this is about Paleozoic era, right? So in Paleozoic era, you can see these animals evolved. Then after Mesozoic era, reptiles evolved. Okay, dinosaur and the reptiles. Then in Cenozoic era, mammals evolved. Okay, so this column shows the evolution. Yes, unicellular organisms, then little bit higher, then land animals like amphibians, okay, fish, amphibians and reptiles and mammals. Okay, now this is about evolution of living beings. Then after climatic changes, you can see climatic changes over here. Yes, now a glacier is in the beginning, actually the earth was very hot in the beginning, and right after that there occurred ice age, glacier age, and igneous and metamorphic rocks were formed. Igneous rock is formed from lava of volcanic mountain. Okay, this is the parent rock. This is the rock which was first from on the earth. So igneous rock, metamorphic rock is the change form of rock from igneous rock. Okay, under pressure and temperature inside the earth, metamorphic rock is formed. Gneiss and granite rocks were formed. Gold and iron metals, heavy metals were formed. Okay, and in Paleozoic, this one is Paleozoic era, sedimentary rocks were formed. Yeah, the formation of sedimentary rock and uniform with the climate. Yes, warm climate, ice age returned because it caused extinction. Now, birth of modern mountains, climatic belt were starting to form. Mesozoic era, modern mountains and the hills. In Cenozoic era, also modern mountains and the hills were formed. Right, cooling down of the earth and climatic belts were formed. Yes, climatic condition came to be stable at this time. So this is about the changes taking place in climatic condition. Yes, so geographical changes are also shown over here, because igneous rock and metamorphic rock was formed in the beginning. Then in this Paleozoic era, sedimentary rock, and Cenozoic, Mesozoic and Cenozoic era, hills and mountains were formed, and climate also became stable gradually. Right, so this is about geological time scale. Now, what questions will be asked from this topic, we'll see in the next video. Okay, mainly you have to study eras over here. Yes, then the periods, Triassic, Jurassic, Cretaceous period. Then few questions from these organisms, which organism appeared in which era. For example, fish originated in which era, toad originated in which era, angiosperms originated in which era. Yes, gymnosperms originated in which era. Yes, fawn plants, pteridophyte originated and evolved which era. This type of questions will be there from this column. Right, we'll see in the note part. So Paleozoic era is also called the era of amphibians, because amphibians were abundant. They dominated the earth's surface during this time. Mesozoic era is also called the era of reptiles or the creepers, because at this time reptiles, dinosaurs dominated the earth. Okay, in Mesozoic era, Triassic period, dinosaurs originated. Jurassic, dinosaurs evolved, developed, and in Cretaceous period, dinosaurs got extinct. So this way, reptiles dominated earth in this time. Cenozoic era is called the era of amphibians, because this time amphibians started living on the earth, and all kinds of mammals started living, and they are still developing. And human beings originated 2 million years ago, Pleistocene. We call it Pleistocene time, right? And human beings dominating earth at this time, recent time, Holocene. So human beings have dominated the earth surface 2 million years ago, Pleistocene epoch. Okay, quaternary period, right? So the caveman appeared at that time. Okay, evolution of humans started right from here, from this epoch, and Pleistocene 2 million year ago human beings appeared, originated, caveman, in the form of caveman appeared on the earth.